Hey, welcome back to the Puget Sound's Finest. Tom Lowe here. Many of you know that I really love architecture, and one of my favorite things is to walk around Tacoma and look at some of the old architecture that was built back around the turn of the 19th century. Florence is known for its architecture as well, and this building is sort of based off of an Italian villa. So you see the arched windows here, very French. The building was modeled after an Italian villa. Much like the Spanish steps, it is sort of a calling back to Italy. And if you go to Florence, you can see buildings modeled that look just like this. So I guess we have a little taste of Florence here in Tacoma. Yeah, and as you can see from this angle, you really get a sense of these arched windows, very Italian villa sort of style, and something that the Midwestern businessmen that were moving here from the Midwest, shocking, because this was a railroad town. This was the terminus for the Northern Pacific Railroad. And so there's all these goods and people were moving out here to make their fortunes. And the city hall here was here to greet them. They had styled it off of many of the city halls in the Midwest back in the time. And so it's really a testament to that time period and a testament to all those businessmen that moved here to really turn Tacoma into sort of a really thriving metropolis back in the early 1900s. It's a five-story structure with a large clock tower. And the clocks actually do have bells in them, built by the same company that built the Liberty Bell out in Baltimore. That was shipped out here, obviously. They weigh about 8,000 pounds, which is like, what, 4 ton? That's a lot of metal at the top of that clock tower. They haven't worked for quite a few years. And in March of 2019, the city council here in Tacoma decided to go ahead and sell the building to a company called basically Surge Tacoma, and they are in the process now of refurbishing it. We're supposed to have micro apartments, two restaurants, a speakeasy, and a bunch of shops throughout the building, kind of refurbished, bring it all back. Here at the cornerstone, you can see that E.A. Hatherton was the architect. He's from San Francisco, with W. Travis and Sixland are the contractors there, finished in 1893. The base of the building here is 8 feet thick, so when the bombs start falling, you probably want to run to here. It's not going anywhere soon. As you go up the building, you'll see that it's covered in a terracotta brick. And these bricks were used as ballast, so legend goes, that came in from a ship from China or Belgium, or probably both. But kind of cool that the ship was bringing in all this brick to use as ballast in their bellies and then recycled, basically, and used in our city hall, old city hall. It is just below the Spanish steps there at McMiniman's, and you can see that video right up here somewhere. Just click on that and you can find out all about the Spanish steps here in Tacoma. Again, a great architectural space, the Elks Lodge and stuff. This hall was used until the mid-1950s, and then it sat kind of vacant. It's had various owners and stuff, kind of fell into disrepair and kind of was a blight here in the city, and we are hoping that it gets replaced by something as nice and as beautiful as McMiniman's up the street. And again, all the revitalization of the north side here of Tacoma. Some great architecture. Take your time, walk around the building, kind of see it. We can't get inside it yet, but as soon as we can, I will be giving you a tour. Anyway, Tom Lowe again, and we will talk to you soon. Thanks for stopping by, and bye.